Jim, do you have an update on Wilton yet on his condition?
Yeah, if we were playing a game this week, he wouldn't be able to play, and we'll assess it as we go. Somebody asked me, Angelique, somebody asked me what I thought of the play after having seen it now. Thought it was egregious. If I had a stronger word to use, I would use it, but with all the emphasis on protecting defenseless players and it appeared that the player knew what he was doing, targeted the head and neck area, and the player was on the ground and accelerated into it. Surprised me, I have two officials standing back there that are both looking at it, plus a review in the press box of that wasn't that wasn't a targeting, that wasn't a personal foul.
Is that something that you contact Big Ten about? And, I mean, there were other hits in that game too.
Yeah. There was a. We'll contact them. And
I mean, what do you get? I mean, when you do contact,
what's the paper back? Yeah, it says they agree or disagree. Yeah. For the short explanation.
So it doesn't really solve anything.
All the emphasis has been placed on the safety of the game, et cetera. I think needs to be addressed. Needs to be answered. And the other thing, in a very good spirited way, we are going to look at everything we can do for the visiting team here at the University of Michigan as it relates to a standard of care for the visitors on multiple levels. But, it's become apparent after going around to all the, the visiting schools in the last couple of years, that a conscious effort of gamesmanship that is unsportsmanlike. when you have locker rooms that are too small, they're not either cooled properly. In this case, there's no air conditioning. Such a tight, cramped environment. We have to open the doors to get some kind of ventilation going in a very small area. People walking by, they're watching you dress. Number of urinals or bathrooms for the players, staff. I think there was two. There was not even private door around it. And then mainly the health and safety of the players. Very, very small space for a training room that had nothing in it. This is no different than facility I think I saw when I was there in 1986. And I'm not putting this on Purdue. This is league-wide. It needs to be addressed by the league. It needs to be addressed by the commissioner. And we're going to lead the way. We're going to look at what we have, but there needs to be a way to X-ray a player at the stadium. There has to be a minimum standard of care for the players. Again, we put a lot of emphasis into health and safety of the players, but it's letting it seem sanitary. You were all in there. We already talked about the heat. And it seems to be a conscious effort to gamesmanship, get an advantage over the opponent. I wish I'd have taken a picture of the actual table that is given to the visitors to put the players on when they're injured. I mean, it looks like it's from the 20s. It was ripped. It's just not good. And I think that's a pattern. In the Big Ten, I asked Don Brown, did you see the same thing in the ACC? Not to this extent. Did not see it to this extent in the Pac-12 when we coached there. And you can keep going on. injured players that can't get an x-ray, take it to a student health center in a van. We needed a brace for a player. There wasn't one at the facility we were taken to. There's a lot of things that needs to be addressed. And talked to Ward about it, and I would ask that the rest of the Big Ten coaches look into this as well and make this a priority, because this is all, we're talking about all of our players here. And we'll start first with us and make sure that you have guests, you have visitors that are coming in, and their health and safety needs are being addressed.
Thank you.